Hello children, this is the second video of the chapter clauses. In the last class we have studied about what is a clause, what is main clause and subordinate clause, and what are adjective clauses. So we have studied that there are three types of subordinate clauses. The first one is adjective clause, about which we have studied in the last class. Second is adverb clause, and third is noun clause. So now let us begin with adverb clause. Adverb clause. Now what is an adverb clause? A subordinate clause which does the work of an adverb and add additional information about verb is called an adverb clause. Means it gives us additional information about verb. Example, the arrow fell where the giant was sleeping. Now ask the question, where did the arrow fall? The answer will be where the giant was sleeping. So it is giving additional information about the verb fell. Second example, she spoke as if she knew everything about the incident. Ask the question, how did she speak? And the answer will be as if she knew everything about the incident. So this, what is written in red color, is the adverb clause. Now there are different types of adverb clauses, and about that we'll study in detail. First one is adverb clause of time. It indicates when the action was carried out by the verb. And to find out adverb of time, we find the main verb in the sentence and then ask the question when. Suppose the question sentence is, he will have dinner after he finishes your work. So now ask the question, when will he have dinner? And the answer will be after he finishes your work. So after he finishes your work is the adverb clause of time. And the introductory words for adverb clauses of time are when, whenever, before, after, till, since, as soon as, while. Now second one is adverb clause of place. It shows the place where the action was carried out by the verb. And to find out adverb clause of place, we find the main verb in the sentence and then ask the question where, in relation to the verb. For example, the arrow fell where the giant was sleeping. Where did the arrow fall? The answer will be where the giant was sleeping, and that is the adverb clause of place. And it begins with the introductory words where, wherever. Third is adverb clause of reason. It shows the reason why the action indicated in the verb is carried out. Means why something happened. We eat so that we may live. Why do we eat? The answer is so that we may live. So it is the adverb clause of reason or the purpose. Next is adverb clause of manner. It shows how the action indicated by the verb is carried out. To identify this clause, we ask the question how. She spoke as if she knew everything about the incident. How did she speak? As if she knew everything about the incident. So that is the adverb clause of manner. Now adverb clause of condition. It shows the condition under which the action was carried out. Like, you will not reach the station in time unless you start now. So unless you start now is the adverb clause of condition. and it begins with the words like if, unless, whether, provided that, so long as. Now, adverb clause of comparison. They show comparison in degree or manner. And it begins with the conjunction than or as adverb as. Example, he is older than he looks. So, than he looks is the adverb clause of comparison. Adverb clause of reason. It shows the result of the action of the verb. Means what was the result? Anita reached school early so that her friends would not have to wait for her. So here, so that her friends would not have to wait for her is the adverb clause of reason. After adverb clause, now we'll study about noun clause. A noun clause acts like a noun in a sentence. It can be the subject, the object, or the complement of the verb. It is introduced by the word that or the question words why, what, how, if, and whether. Example, I do not know how we did it. Now, how we did it is a noun clause and it is the object of the verb know. Know what? How we did it is the noun clause. Second one, that he is going to get the job is certain. Now here, that he is going to get the job is the noun clause and it is the subject of the verb is. What is certain? That he is going to get the job is certain. In the third sentence, give the money to whoever needs it. Give what? The money. To whom? To whoever needs it. So it is the indirect object. Now what he said was true. What was true? What he said. He tells that he will not go. Now what does he tell? He tells that he will not go. So here that he will not go is the noun clause. So I hope children clauses are clear to you all.